the Prime Minister had announced that every branch must fund at least one SCST or and a woman entrepreneur. Requirements of the agricultural sector, housing and urban poverty alleviation, educational loans, food processing, rural development, textiles. These are subjects which are being discussed. And now the investment in the solar energy sector must be under current discussion as I speak to you. The second limb of the discussions relates to the various social security programs of the government and the contribution of both the PSBs and even the private sector banks to all these programs. So the progress of the Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, the two insurance sector schemes, the pension scheme, the Mudra Yojana, were all reviewed, and the roadmap for the rest of the financial year was discussed. By and large, there has been an overwhelming response to most of these schemes, and it was agreed that this impetus be continued. The health of the public sector banks, of course, was also a key subject, particularly in relation to the fact that a carried over problem of the past continues to persist. And that problem really relates to unacceptable level of NPAs and impaired assets as far as the banks are concerned. We did have a discussion almost in relation to certain specific banks also. The overall health of the economy and how various sectors are doing, because part of the stress was also caused on account of factors which are attributable to certain sectors. Hopefully, the reforms that have been announced in the power sector, once they are worked out, the stress caused by DISCOMs would give way. The highway sector has started moving. There were issues relating to pending problems of EPC contractors, which then impinge on the construction industry. Now, a series of steps have been announced recently by the government relating to quick resolution of those disputes which have caused stress in that sector. Problems relating to the steel sector, where several steps of a revenue nature have been taken by the government, were discussed. Several suggestions have been offered by the bankers in relation to both steel and aluminium. Some of them have been examined by the Department of Revenue, and the Secretary DFS would be coordinating further discussions between the banks and the Department of Revenue as to what other proactive policy steps are required to be taken in order to improve the health as far as the banks are concerned. The banks themselves are conscious of the fact that account by account they have to sort out issues relating to a certain category of their own debtors. And the challenge is that the banking system, which is the lifeline of the economy, continues to fund various segments of the economy in order to grow. Now that the growth rates are somewhat picking up, and therefore the pressures of the past need to be removed as far as possible. In fact, it was a very structured discussion on each of these subjects which has been held today. Thank you. That's all I have to say. You see, the situation is going to improve for the better. And why I say it will going to improve for the better, I am not really concerned with the transient problem. The transient problem obviously will remain because the credit offtake has to pick up and the recoveries have to improve. But the series of steps which the Reserve Bank has announced, which some of the banks have been implementing, will certainly improve on the quality of those assets. Additionally, the government also has been extremely proactive in responding to each of the sectors. Now, results of this don't come overnight. But then once the process has been set into motion, which was stagnant for a reasonable period of time, I think the situation will improve significantly in a reasonable time.
So you mentioned about Department of Revenue having made some corrections. So is this regarding certain sectors like steel and aluminium, duty front, as you've done earlier?
You see, there are problems of each sector have to be separately addressed. The Department of Revenue comes in only to, along with the Ministry of Commerce, only to objectively assess where global factors are causing domestic stress. That is, if there is a sudden and an unnatural surge at unacceptable prices, it's only then that the Ministry of Commerce and the Department of Revenue comes in. The banks as creditors have made some suggestions and observations. It's for the other two ministries to objectively consider the facts within the parameters of law. देखिए, ब्रांचेस का आज अभाव बहुत कठिनाई नहीं है. कारण ये है कि ब्रांचेस पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक्स की हैं. जहां कुछ क्षेत्रों में नहीं है वहां बन भी सकती है और उसमें कोई तकलीफ नहीं है. बैंकिंग कॉरेस्पॉन्डेंट्स हैं, टेक्नोलॉजी का इस्तेमाल है, पोस्ट ऑफिसेज हैं, ये सारे आज बैंक के ढांचों में आ गए हैं. और जो ये बैंकिंग लाइसेंसेस पोस्ट वगैरह पोस्ट ऑफिसेज को मिले हैं, उससे ये विस्तार बहुत फैलने वाला है. इसलिए प्रश्न ब्रिक एंड मोर्टर ब्रांचेस का नहीं है. ये जो सारी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन है, जो जितने भी टेक्नोलॉजी के प्लेटफॉर्म्स बने हैं, उन सब के माध्यम से उन लोगों तक पहुंचना. जैसे अभी तक हम लोग कहते थे कि स्कॉलरशिप्स, पेंशन्स, ये बैंक खातों में जाती थी. उसके बाद कुकिंग गैस की सब्सिडी जाने लग पड़ी. अभी सेक्रेटरी रूरल डेवलपमेंट ने जो प्रेजेंटेशन दिया है कि बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में मनरेगा का पैसा भी जाने लग पड़ा है. तो अगर 12 करोड़ से ज्यादा लोगों को कुकिंग गैस सब्सिडी जा रही है और लगभग 9 करोड़ लोग हैं जिनको मनरेगा का वेतन जाता है, और इस बार काफी उसमें वृद्धि हुई है, जितनी संख्या लोग मनरेगा का प्रयोग करते थे, क्योंकि मौसम एक उसमें कारण रहा है, तो इसलिए बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में उनके खातों में भी अब जा रहा है पैसा. तो वो जो सरकार की योजना थी वो ट्रैक पे है. देखिए, दैट्स वो विषय सरकार अलग से उस पर विचार कर रही है, आज की बैठक में नहीं था. नहीं, देयर इज नॉट अ सब्जेक्ट मैटर इन टुडेज मीटिंग. देखिए, गोल्ड बॉन्ड स्कीम जो है, क्योंकि उसका प्राइस फिक्सेशन ऐसा होता है कि कुछ दिनों के लिए खुलती है, फिर उसको हम बंद करते हैं, फिर जो करंट बाजार होगा उसके लिए दोबारा खुलती है. तो वो ट्रेंचेस में उसके लिए खुलेगी. जहां तक मोनेटाइजेशन का प्रश्न है, अभी उसका पूरा एपरेटस जिसमें गोल्ड की टेस्टिंग हो रही है वो एस्टैब्लिश होकर सेटअप किया जा रहा है।
मंत्री जी, हमारा ये पूछ रहे आपसे कि माइनोरिटीज को जो एरिया में एसटीएससी तो बनारस और मुरादाबाद वगैरह में माइनोरिटीज को कितने लोन को बढ़ावा मिला है?
देखिए अभी पूरी संख्या नहीं है, लेकिन जब उसमें अगर आप चाहें मैं ला दूंगा उसकी, वो पता कर लेंगे डिपार्टमेंट से, लेकिन जो पूरी बैंकिंग सिस्टम का लोन है उसमें स्वाभाविक है माइनॉरिटी भी उसका एक हिस्सा है। ऑफकोर्स व्हेन वी टुक एन असेसमेंट ऑफ सर्टन बैंक्स विच हैड अ हायर लेवल ऑफ एनपीएस, द फैक्ट इज टू सम पर्टिकुलर डिफॉल्टर्स which is a common thread running across several banks, did crop up for discussion. Because this meeting is meant to be serious business, and that's a part of serious business.
Sir, any assurance to bankers
that you will give them more powers to
deal with enforcement of contracts? They have all the powers. But some bankers have been
saying that when it comes to... There are to deal with developing situations, there are several important steps which are involved. One step was that the government today has given highest levels of autonomy as far as bank functioning is concerned. Secondly, the RBI as a part of its progressive policies in relation to defaulters has further empowered the banks. Thirdly, if we are able to expeditiously pass the bankruptcy law, the ability of banks to get failed creditors to exit itself will increase. For resolution of issues, particularly pending in various contractual matters, EPCs and construction contracts and public contracts, we've already have an ordinance now, law in place with regard to fast track disposal through arbitrations, which says the dispute to be resolved within 6 months, and if objections are filed, a certain quantum of amount has to be deposited in court. Now these are all a part of those steps which are going to continuously empower the banks so that they can undertake their effective banking functions.
So there are five banks which are close to the status of IOB where the RBI has put protections. Now their NPLs are at all time high. Now are you asking banks to differentiate, because you have been asking it for the last 1 year but nothing has happened. Are you asking them to differentiate, and what is the status of the resolution which you had implemented? Because we have seen nothing so far in this case that their NPA ratios are improving.
No, the NPA ratios...
And are their banks are going...
Dekhe, the banks are maintaining a practice where the correct positions are coming on surface. And therefore, we must know where the problem lies in order to resolve the problems. As far as the Indradhanush is concerned, several steps have already been implemented. The first tranche of money to go into the banks has already gone.
Yes. So on the question of increased credit offtake, so despite the strong trade action by the RBI, have you not tried to what the reason for the lack of increased credit offtake is?
Lack of?
Increased credit offtake, so doesn't work. And
you see, the economy is gradually picking up. And therefore, as demand picks up, and certainly that offtake itself will also pick up. I agree with you that it could be faster in the larger health of the economy itself.
Sir, so what about credit? Bank of Baroda ki ghatna ke baad se jo steps uthaye gaye sarkar ki taraf se banko mein paradarshita rahne ke liye, uske liye kya baithak mein baat ki thi?
Dekhiye, wo ek fraud case hai, aur isliye jo bhi fraud karta hai usme wo ek apraadh hai. और इसलिए बैंक उसमें जो भी कार्रवाई है क्रिमिनल लॉ प्रोसेस के थ्रू और अपने साधन वापस लेने के लिए उनके खिलाफ वो करेगा।